So now I am going to take the question number 11. A particle is thrown up with a speed root 3 gr by 2 from surface of earth. The maximum height attained by the particle is. So this question, once again, you can use the law of conservation of mechanical energy. So total energy at the surface will be equal to the total energy at maximum height. So I am going to write first total energy at surface, that is minus G capital M small m by R, and the kinetic energy 1 by 2 M. I need speed, and you know very well speed is root 3 gr, but there is no need of root because formula of kinetic energy is half mv square. So we'll write 3 gr upon 2, and that is equal to the potential energy as per the situation mm, and position will be r plus h. And because question says the maximum height, so final kinetic energy will be 0. So this is my equation. So I have minus g mm by r plus 1 by 4 3 mgr, that is equal minus gmm r plus h. But I need to calculate maximum height small h. So when you will solve this equation, this is a simple equation, will get h equal 3r on solving. So my option number 3 is correct. So let's move on question number 12. In the question number 12, which of the following statement is correct? If any number of masses at rest are placed close to each other, then their binding energy must be negative. No, binding energy will be positive. So first option will not correct. Escape speed of a particle depends on its mass. No, this is not correct because escape speed is given by root 2 gr, and if I place the value of small g, so this is gm by r square, where m is the mass of earth, or jahan se isko aap project karoge uska mass, projected body ka mass nahi hai. So we can say option number 2 will not correct. The work required to bring two masses closer slowly is always negative. Yes, you know very well this is correct. So we can say my option number 3 is correct. Let's move on question number 13. In the question number 13, the point where gravitational field is zero in the given arrangement is at distance x from 4m. The value of x is. So now I am going to solve. This is the situation. 4m is here and 9m. Suppose this is our required point and the position of this point is x from 4m side. So now if I calculate the gravitational force, so first force is F1 applied by 4m, another force is F2 applied by 9m, and if I consider the mass of this point, mass is m0. So you are seeing that F1 and F2 are in opposite, and if the magnitude of F1 is equal to magnitude of F2, then we will find gravitational field zero at this point. So if I use this condition, so we'll write the value of F1 g, first mass is 4m and point mass is m0, separation between them is x square. Similarly, if I go another side, so g, the first mass is 9m and second mass is m0, and the separation between, because the total separation of the masses is d, so the remaining distance will be d minus x. So this is d minus x with the square. So capital G M M naught, capital G M M naught will cancel out, and I have only 4 upon x square and 9 upon d minus x with whole square. So if I go for calculation, so we'll write d minus x upon x, that is equal 9 upon 4 with the root, because x and d minus x in terms of square. So if I take d upon x minus x upon x is equal to 1, and I have 3 by 2. So value of d upon x is 3 by 2 plus 1, so that is 5 by 2, and I need the value of x, so x upon d is 2 upon 5, so that will give you x is equal 2 upon 5 into d. So this is the position from 4m. So on behalf of that, we can say my option number 3 is correct. So let's move on to question number 14. So first I am going to read the question number 14. The ratio of two planet, the ratio of radius of two planet, 3 is 4. So R1 upon R2 is 3 by 4. And their densities, rho 1 and rho 2, if I consider rho is the density, so this is 1 by 2. The ratio of escape speed on their surface is, and we know the escape speed is given by 2 times of gm upon r, where m is the mass of earth, if the particle is projected from the earth. So now I need to convert this mass in terms of density. So we'll write, because mass can be converted in terms of density by using volume 4 by 3 pi r cube into density. So when I will place this value, root 2 times g, and mass is 4 by 3 pi r cube into density divided by r. So when I will take the variables, so we'll write escape speed is proportional to radius with the density. Because 4g is constant, 4 upon 3 pi r is constant, and this radius r and density is variable in this question. So I need this relation, and this is my relation number 1. So if I use this, and if I go for the ratio V1 upon V2, so by using equation number 1, we can write R1 for first, R2 for second, and similarly for density, rho 1 upon rho 2. And now, if I place the value of R1 upon R2, that is 3 by 4, ratio of density is 1 by 2. So when I will place the value R1 upon R2, 3 by 4, and density is 1 by 2. So on solving, agar main 4 ko root ke andar lekar jaun, it will convert in terms of square. So I have 3 upon 16 into 2, 32. So this is the final ratio, 3 upon root 32. So we can say my option number 1 is correct. So let's move on question number 15. If I go for question number 15, if force of gravitation varies f directly proportional to r square, then the orbital speed of satellite v naught will proportional to, where r is the radius of orbit. So according to the problem, we can write force is directly proportional to r square, and if I use a proportionality constant k, so this is k r square, and this force will provide centripetal force. So we'll write k r square is equal to mv naught square by r. So k is the constant, as I said, and mass is constant, so k r cube is equal to mv naught square. But I want to find the relation between V naught and R. So there is no hesitation. We can say V naught is directly proportional to R to the power 3 by 2 because R cube is there and V square is there. So final relation is V naught proportional to R to the power 3 by 2. So my option number 3 is correct. And let's move on question number 16.